Hello everyone, today let's discuss about the post-operative period complications. Now during the first 24 hours, the patient is very critical and you have to monitor them very critically. For this period, the patient is placed in a special ward or a unit called the recovery unit, which may be close to the operation theater. Now the patient is just recovering from anesthesia, and anesthesia can make the body a bit cold. I mean, it reduces the body temperature. So you have to keep the patient warm, cover him or her by blankets, and monitor them carefully. Now, let's look at some of the demonstration on some common complications on the post-operative period. And we will discuss some which are to be reported to the nurse immediately. Now, let us look over to a demonstration. The patient just had her appendix removed and she is coming out of anesthesia. So let's go and see the possible discomforts and what we should do in these cases. Let's go. Good evening, ma'am. How are you feeling today?
I'm fine, but I'm dry and I'm thirsty.
Yeah, I can see your lips are dry. Please open your mouth for me. Yeah, your mouth also seems dry. Let me check your input and output info. Okay, I can see the input and output info. Do you want maybe some ice chips?
No, I'm not good at cold.
Okay, then I'm increasing your output. Sorry, I'm increasing your input of liquids, okay? In the meantime, let me bring you a glass of water, alright? Carefully. I hope you're feeling better after that glass of water. I'll have to check your BP, ma'am. Alright?
Yeah.
Please put your hands forward. Carefully, please. Okay, I'll pick that up. Put your hands in. Start with the compressions, okay? Okay, it seems good. Okay, don't worry about anything. I've already increased the input. I see you're having hiccups.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll remove this pillow for you. Okay, just take rest. Right? Here, take this paper bag. Try and breathe into it, okay? Try and breathe into it. Breathe, and then breathe out. Okay, breathe in. Breathe out. Just repeat it for a minute. It will go away. Don't worry about it, okay? So ma'am, everything okay for now?
Yeah, a little pain is there.
Okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the least severe and 10 being the most severe pain, what do you feel?
5 or 6.
About 5 or 6?
Yeah.
Okay, just let me check. There are no signs of any hemorrhage. Does it pain?
A little bit.
Okay. I'll ask the nurse to increase your anti-pain meds if possible. Okay?
Okay?
For now, let me put a pillow right here. Okay? This will at least add you a bit of comfort. Okay?
Much better, thank you.
Much better, nahi bolna. What happened, ma'am? Are you feeling discomfort?
Yeah, a bit nausea.
Nausea? Yeah. Okay. I can see your input-output table. Is it okay if I replace some of the fluid-free foods by solid meals?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Try and deep breathe, okay? Deep breathe. It doesn't pain right now, right?
No.
Try and deep breathe, okay? We'll take care.
Now, the possible discomfort can also be serious. For example, hemorrhage, which is excessive blood loss. In these cases, you can see in the patient fall in blood pressure, cold, moist skin, weak and or rapid pulse, restlessness. So in this case, report to the nurse immediately. Also, there is another condition called shock. In this condition, the pressure in blood pressure will fall. The patient will be weak. There will be rapid pulse, discoloration, moist skin, etc. In this case, again, report to the nurse immediately. In case of hypoxia, that is the lack of oxygen, there will be restlessness in the patient, dryness, crowing sound to the respiration, pounding pulse. Give her an oxygen mask and report to the nurse immediately. In case of atelectasis, that is decreased or absent air in all part of the lung, resulting in the loss of lung volume and inability to expand lung. So in case of atelectasis, there will be dyspnea, cyanosis, pallor. So in this case, report to the nurse immediately. Also in case of wound infection or wound disruption, you can see a pinkish drainage. Complain by the patient that she can feel open or broken or given away or increase in the incisional area, fever, chills, damage or in the dressing. In this case, again, report to the nurse immediately. Also in case of pulmonary emboli, there will be anxiety, difficulty breathing, feelings of heaviness in the chest, cyanosis and chest pain. In this case, again, report to the nurse immediately.